Hello, everyone. We're here at Athens Limestone Hospital, and I just had the pleasure of meeting Dr. Jimmy Dunn. Check out this title. Chief of Anesthesiology of Athens Limestone Hospital. And you said what?
And I said, Chief is good. I'll take that.
Hey, well, nobody complains.
Nobody complains.
Well, a few things that we have to do right now is say nice colors, nice friendly hat.
Nice friendly hat covers up the unfriendly head.
You are seeing Jamie right now in that head full of hair.
It's disgusting.
It is that. Well, you, now tell me, you have been here how long in Athens?
18 years.
18 years.
Mm-hmm.
It's a long time.
That is a long time. This was my first job, and I've loved it and stayed here ever since.
Well, nice. Well, you must know almost everyone in the community already.
I know a lot of people. A lot of people.
They do. Now, you don't necessarily call you up and say, hey, I want an appointment. Tell us what you do.
No, they should not do that. That's illegal, actually, to do that.
Oops.
What we do is when the patients come in, they're scheduled for surgery, and then we, as anesthesiologists, we interview most of the patients, prep them for surgery, answer their questions, get them ready to go. They come to the operating room. They go into an operating suite, normally with a CRNA. We then supervise the anesthetic or medically direct the anesthetic, however you want to look at that. And then once the patient completes their procedure, we go to recovery room with them, manage the patients in recovery room if they have any sort of problems, if they have pain issues, nausea issues, whatever. Mm-hmm. We make sure they're stable there. We sign them out and send them back out to either ODA or to the floor where their family doctors or surgeons will take over from there.
So it's very important for people to be comfortable with you when they're in that hospital room, or if they're nervous, scared. Do you ever answer any questions?
We have to interact with the patients fairly quickly, and we have to get them off the ledge. Anesthesia is a scary thing for a lot of people. A lot of people have never had it done. There's a lot of questions. People have had problems or complications before. So we do a fair amount of talking people down. We also do a fair amount of talking people down with chemicals, which works also.
Okay.
But we've tried to get away from some of that and tried to use more of the personal interactions, mm-hmm. And just establishing a relationship with the patient and making them comfortable that way and staying away from more of the other things.
That would make you feel a lot better, too, calming your nerves where you don't need other things added to your body as you go into that procedure.
Well, and it also helps us on the other end. The more things we give you, sedating things or narcotics or whatever, it's harder to get you up at the end. And really, in the modern surgical arena, it's all about getting you in and getting you out.
Right.
Years ago, if you want to lay in the hospital 2 days, that's fine. But now we're getting you out of the operating room, back to ODA, put you in a car, and send you home. And that's the way that the modern medicine works. So we have to be part of that team concept as far as getting the patients through the surgery and yet getting them ready to go. And that would hinder us somewhat if we were using heavy-handed tactics at the beginning of the case.
Hmm. How many surgeries does your group oversee per year?
About 400 a month.
Wow.
Is about average.
A month.
About between 4,500 and 5,000 a year, depending on fluctuations in economy and insurance and whatever else, people's sicknesses, whatever.
I was not expecting 450 a month. That's a lot.
It's a lot.
It sure is. Well, what is one thing you can tell your patients when they're nervous? How do you make them feel better?
Well, I usually try to find some way to connect with them, and oftentimes we can use humor, or we can use common experiences. There's a lot of things you can do. It's sort of I'm not saying it's a talent, it's really more of a skill you sort of develop over time. We have such a short time to interact with these patients, and oftentimes we don't know them.
Mm-hmm.
And we have to figure out sort of where they're coming from, what their concerns are, and then address those concerns quickly. And I think that most patients, if they feel like you're listening to them and that you're addressing their concerns, even if their concerns, either from their standpoint or mine, are not reasonable.
Right. They may not be talking, that's right.
They may, and you know, sometimes I may think their concerns are a little silly, or they may think the question is silly, but we work through all that, and I think what we try to do is just establish some level of communication, some rapport there, whether it's humor or other things, to sort of get them relaxed and get them. And then the other thing is trying to take the time.
Right.
I think people, especially physicians, we're busy, we're moving, we're kind of these kind of folks.
Behind schedule.
Behind schedule,
gotta go.
There's always someone pushing you, but the patient really wants to feel special. They want this. They want to feel like they have your undivided attention, and that you're addressing all their concerns in an appropriate professional manner. And they don't want to feel like you're just rushing in there and, well, I got to go, and you're not. This is no big deal, gotta go. So we have a, it's a skill set. It develops over time. Not near as good at it 18 years ago as I am now. And that's just part and parcel of the practice of medicine, just getting better at what you do all the time.
Well, I had some official questions on
here,
but forget those for a moment, because after you just said that last statement about a little bit better now than 18 years ago, you can tell you're very comfortable and you enjoy what you do.
I'm comfortable now. I think whenever you first start, there's always some apprehension. You come out of training, you feel like, I mean, you're smart, you've got all the data in your mind, you're ready to go from that standpoint, but you've never actually put yourself out there with a patient and saying, it's me. It's not my attending, it's not another doctor, it's not a team. It's Jimmy Dunn and this patient, and my name is on that chart. And now this patient has put their confidence in me as a practicing physician, not as a trainee. So there's a lot of I don't want to say uncertainty, but it certainly it challenges you really to go forward. But then as you become more comfortable with it down the road, then I feel very comfortable now talking with the patients, and I feel like I'm able to establish a rapport. I'm able to take care of the patients medically, psychologically, all the things that go with anesthesia, and I do feel a lot more comfortable. But it took time to get there.
Well, that is great. Congratulations. It's been a joy talking with you,
and
I know you've made probably all of Limestone County and others happy.
Well, come see us. We're right here. I've been here 18 years.
Okay,
I'm not going anywhere.
You don't have
to come see me, but if you want to, we'll be glad to take care of you.
Well, definitely. Thank you very much.
Yes.
Athens Limestone Hospital, I'm sure, is very proud to have you here.
Thank you.